Hi students, in the previous topic we had discussed about direct memory access, where input-output processor monitors the data transfer between memory and I/O devices. Okay, now in this topic we are going to look at input-output processor itself. And in our textbook, Maurice Mano discussed about two I/O input-output processors. One is IBM 370 made by IBM. The other one is Intel 8089. Okay, so let us start with IBM 370. Okay, IBM people call it as channel. So whenever I use the word channel, that means I am talking about input output processor. Okay, now there are three types of channels. One is multiplexer, another one is selector, another one is block multiplexer. Multiplexer channel is designed to work with slow to medium speed data transfer devices, and it can work with number of devices simultaneously, whereas the selector type channel is designed to work with faster data transfer devices, and it can work with one device at a time. And block multiplexer type channel is a mix of both. It can handle faster, slow or medium pace data transfer rate I/O devices, or fast data transfer rate I/O devices also. Okay, these are the different types of channels that are available. Okay, now these I/O processors are used by the CPU by writing the I/O instructions and channel status words, channel command words. So we should know, let us look at these instruction formats, channel status word format, channel command format, to get better understanding of these I/O processors and how the CPU will be accessing this I/O processor to deal with input output devices. Okay, let us start with this input output instruction format. Okay, this instruction format is having three parts. One is operation code. So CPU can use the I/O processor to do various operations. So all those operations are having some code. So this IBM 370 is used for to execute 8 different operations: start I/O operation, start I/O, fast release operation, test I/O operation, clear I/O operation, halt I/O operation, halt the device, test channel, store channel ID. Such I/O instructions can be performed by the CPU with the help of I/O processor. For that purpose, it has to mention the operation code. And the second field is channel address. That means CPU can be connected with more than one channel. Okay, as I told you, this is IBM 370 one channel. This channel is used to connect with multiple I/O devices. Similarly, one computer can be using more than one channel, and each and every channel can have multiple I/O devices. So channel address is required and device address is also required to perform any I/O instruction with the help of input output processor. So this is the first one. Now after the channel is selected, channel status word format, CPU might be interested to know the status of the channel. In the previous topic we had seen how the channel and how the CPU and IOP communicates between them. So before using the input output processor, CPU first checks the status. It wants to see whether the I/O processor is available for the operation or not. And then if the status is okay, then only it assigns any work to it. Otherwise it won't. So channel status word is very important for the CPU. Okay, this is the channel status word format. It is having 4 fields. One is key. Okay, that key is a protection from unauthorized access. Okay, one user cannot access other user's data. And address of the last command used by the channel. And status indicates the condition in device and channel, so in which condition the device or channel is available. And count gives the residual count when the transfer was terminated, how many bytes were transferred, how many are remaining. That kind of information is given by this count. So this channel status word is very important. Whenever CPU wants to use input output processor, first it asks for this status word. Okay, let us go to the last one, channel command format, channel command word CCW. It is having four fields: command code, data address, flags, count. Okay, command code, with the help of this field, it is possible to determine which operation is going to be performed. Write, read backwards, control, sense, transferring channel. So there are six basic operations are available. Okay, write means the transfer of data is happening from memory to I/O device. That means CPU wants to send some data to I/O device. If it wants to receive the data, then it will use command read. That means CPU will receive the data from I/O device and that will be stored in the memory. Read backwards. This operation will be used whenever the CPU is accessing a magnetic tape, which is the I/O device. Okay, I/O devices are accessed through I/O processors. Okay, so this kind of command should be given to the I/O processor so that this I/O device will be used. Okay, and to control, control means other than reading and writing. Okay, any other operation. Sense, to this informs the channel to transfer its channel status word. Okay, so sometimes CPU might be interested to know the status of the I/O device, then it will use this command to get the status. Okay, transfer in channel used instead of jump instruction. Here the data address field specifies the address of the next command word to be executed by the channel. So these are the six commands that could be used by the CPU whenever it is using the I/O processor. Here you can see some examples of these channel command words, channel command words, CCWs, write tape. That means the CPU is sending some data onto the magnetic tape at this address, and this many number of bytes are being transferred. Okay. So here address is changed and number of bytes that are going to be transferred also changed. So these are some examples how the CPU is going to use the I/O processor to access the I/O device. What is the I/O device? Magnetic tape. Okay, these many number of bytes are being written, okay, by the CPU. That means these bytes are available in the memory and they are being transferred to the I/O device. Okay, this is the memory map of the IBM. So all these channel status word, address word, all are stored here. You can see, look at it. Now let us look at the input output processor made by Intel. Okay, 8086 is the microprocessor for which this 8089 I/O processor is designed. Okay, so this is the setup used in the DMA, direct memory access data transfer. So these are the peripheral devices which are connected through interface to I/O processor. Whenever they want some DMA, they will send the DMA request to I/O processor, and I/O processor sends the interrupt request to CPU, and CPU will suspend its current program and acknowledges through interrupt acknowledgement INTA, and then I/O processor gives the acknowledgement through DMA acknowledgement. Okay, so I/O processor is also capable of this 8089 I/O processor is also capable of doing DMA, whereas that IBM 370 only takes care of input output devices. Okay, here an additional capability is also available, about which in the previous topic we had discussed. This is available in a 40 pin IC package, and it is having two independent channels. It is also having DMA capability. It is designed to work with 8086, where 8086 access master and 8089 access slave. Okay, in the previous topic we had seen what is the relationship between master and slave. Okay, IBM 370 is capable of executing only six commands, which we have just now we have seen, read, write, something like that. But Intel 8089 can execute 50 instructions. It is almost like a processor, only the instruction set is limited to focus on I/O processing. Okay, so this CPU communicates with this 8089 IO processor with the help of blocks, control block, parameter block. Okay, control block is having two parts, busy flag and CCW. So this flag is used to indicate whether the IO processor is available or not. And CCW, channel command word, is used to start the operation, whichever operation out of those 50 operations, whichever operation CPU wants to do, that operation will be filled here. Okay, that is the purpose of control block. Control block will have the address of parameter block. Now parameter block will have the details required to perform the task in the task block. Task is performed at the IO program, IO processor. Okay, so what are the details required to perform the task? TB address, memory address, byte count, how many number of bytes needs to be transferred, to which device it needs to be transferred. For example, if it is a magnetic disk, then track and sector details are required, and the status is used to represent whether the data is, whether the operation is done or not. So the CPU will communicate with these with the IO processor of 8089 with the help of these control blocks and parameter blocks. Okay, so this is the input output processor concept. So here we had discussed about two types of input output processor. One is made by IBM, the other one is made by Intel. Thank you.